I'm supposed to be running out the door, jacket on, and I forgot to do this video, so I'm going to do it in my steps out the door. Hope all's good. We had an amazing weekend here of Reiki level twos, and last week was the level ones. Fabulous to be back in the energy. I absolutely love it. It's my absolute passion. I would do it for morning to night, and people who know me know that. I have the Reiki Master starting on Wednesday, and that is a full course. There's no more room on that because it literally is such a high energy course, and I have 3 hours on a Wednesday night to do 8 students, and most of them are my own students. Some of them will be refreshing, but most of them are my own students, and it's so intensive I cannot do any more than 8. So a lot of people have been asking me about the different lineages of Reiki that we have. Now I'm a Reiki master, so I'm level 3, even though there's no masters in working with energy. We learn every single day to the moment we die. I always say that, even though we're level 3, so I'm Reiki level 3. So that means I can teach it and I can practice it. When I want to do a Reiki level 1 or 2 or 3 course, I am going to teach you in the same way that I was taught. It's exactly the same way as my Auntie Ethel, who taught me, who was doing it for 40-something years, still doing it, taught me in a traditional way, called Shiki Ryo. Dr Usui is the first generation in that lineage. He was the Christian minister who went on a quest to find out how Jesus healed with his hands, or how Buddha healed with his hands. There's two different perspectives on this. And he went to on a quest for knowledge to find how they were able to do that. And it led him on a quest of going to look in manuals, look in Sanskrit writings, where he saw lots of symbols, lots of information, but he couldn't understand it. In order for him to find the in-depth knowledge, as in the go deeper, he had to do 21 days meditation on a mountain called Mount Koriyama. And he sat up there for 21 days and was given all of the knowledge on the last day, where all the information that he'd read in the books and over his time searching came back to him, and he was full understanding and full knowledge of how the healing was done with the hands. He went on then with that knowledge and then taught Dr. Hayashi. That's the second generation. Dr. Hayashi knew that the Great War was coming at the times in the 1900s, knew the Great War was coming, and he decided to teach it to his wife, and then the third generation, which is Mrs. Takata. So they're the first three generations of the Reiki Shiki Ryo lineage. Mrs. Takata then decided to go on and teach 22 Reiki masters before she died, and the 22 Reiki masters is where it started to branch. Some of them taught it traditionally down the lineage, which is where our lineage came from. But some decided to trademark it to Terame, when you can't trademark energy, by the way. Trademarked it to Terame. Other energy lineages like Angelic Reiki, Rohani Reiki, all of these different branches that came off from the students of Mrs. Takata. Mrs. Takata, one of her students, Iris Urukuru, taught it exactly the same way as Mrs. Takata, Dr. Hayashi, Dr. Usui. So this is the lineage where we are, in that traditional lineage all the way down, Shiki Ryo. My auntie is the 9th generation, I'm the 10th, and my students are the 11th. Lovely number, love it. Right, so when I have somebody who comes to me, and this is because the way I practice, this is not the way everybody does it, this is the way I practice, because my auntie taught me how to do it in this way, and I'll never change the tradition of the way it was taught to me. She's my auntie who's been doing it for, and it's been working for this length of time. She's doing it 40 odd years, right? So I'm never going to change that, because for me it works. That we have the most amazing gifts here with Reiki, which you know, channeling, light language, movement, all of these amazing experiences that are happening with our level one students and some of our clients who come. So it's enough for me. I'm working with this energy 20 years altogether, and this is powerful enough. I don't need to change and have any more symbols than what we already have. So our traditional way of teaching it is that when you do level one, it takes 6 months before you can do level two, because why rush it? The first month is spent Reiki yourself, where you do hands-on healing on yourself first, because you got to help yourself first before you put your hands on others. And then you then will spend the next 5 months doing some work with practicing on friends and family, and also yourself, right? You need the time for the energy to integrate into your body. So why rush that? There's lots of people saying, oh, why can I not do it in 3 months? I have lots of my Reiki masters saying, oh, people are saying we're the only ones that are doing 6 months waiting period. But why? What do you want to rush for? This energy is such a powerful energy. You need to use that energy on yourself first before you go and put it onto others. You got to get to the crap that's in yourself. So what do you want to rush that for? And this is a rushing where people are trying to rush you in the door, get you level one and level two within 3 months. Your master has a different agenda. I don't believe that these things need to be rushed. I think that your experience and working with energy should be slow, and it should be an integration where the energy goes into your body in a nice, easy way. What's for your highest good? And your highest good is not like giving yourself a time scale of 3 months, because people heal differently, right? So between level one and level two, you have got to have 6 months of working with the energy. And then you want to go on then to do level two, which is a practitioner level. For me, I would say between level two and your Reiki Masters is 1 year. So then you would get to practice with the energy with people that you're going to actually charge them for, because you're a practitioner now, and you will then be charging them for. So you've got to have done the work on yourself first, because you're not going to be any good of a practitioner if you're standing over them and something happens within them that they're triggered and they start to cry or release, and then you haven't looked at your stuff and all of a sudden you're crying over them. You're not going to make me look very good as your teacher, right? So when you do level two, it takes the year between level two and level three, which is what I am, and it's the master teacher level, and you go on to become a master teacher. And it's not a master, you know, we say master teacher, I'm a Reiki master, that's ego. There's no Reiki masters out there. We are all learning. I am going to learn till the moment I die, because my students and my clients are still teaching me. So I have a lot of people who are asking me, can they do my level three? You can only do my level three or my level two if you've done my level one. And it doesn't mean my level one with me. It has to be level one in the Shiki Ryo traditional way of doing Reiki, because that's a different lineage to Terame, Rahani, all of these other ones. So the Shiki Ryo has three symbols on Reiki level two: Chokore, Sei Heiki, Hanshe, Sei Shonen. And those three symbols are the symbols that are given to you in an attunement process. I have received them in my attunement process, and then I received two more in my master's. So we only have five symbols. I can't attune you if you're a Terame and you did level one and level two Terame and you want to come to me to do level three, because I don't have your 13 symbols. Terame has around 13 symbols. So I can't do your attunement. So I have to bring you back to the start with me, refresh level one, refresh level two, attune you to those energies, and then bring you forward to Reiki level three, master teacher with me, and the course is done. And the course is in level one, level two, and level three. Courses are done in the right way for me. I want to teach it the way it was taught to me, so I'm not going to teach it in any other way. It's not about rushing for me. It's not about money for me. I'm not in it for that. I don't do it for that reason. And there should be never any rush in doing a Reiki course. If there's a rush and you're trying to get yourself out there to be a Reiki practitioner, there's a different agenda there of wanting to do it as a business. And your guides, your team on the spirit side, will rein you back and will not give you any clients until they know and your higher self knows you are ready. So I know, because I'd done my own course like that. I had two clients that came to me for the first year when I started practicing. Two clients only every week. Every Tuesday night I had two clients. And they were my first two clients that every single week came to me. And it basically, my guys built up my clients. Literally, that those two girls, their friends, their families went out, sparked off others. And then it meant that the word of mouth got around and people came that way. It's not about... Your guides are going to bring people to you the way in your time when you are ready. So it's not like you're going to open a business tomorrow and you just turn and did your Reiki level two this weekend and open a business on Wednesday and all of a sudden you're going to get this influx of clients. It doesn't work like that. The clients come when you're ready, and your guides and their guides are going to work together and bring the guides are going to bring the clients to you, especially the clients to you who are resonating or there's a matching of vibrational energies with. So anyone who asks me to do a level two, I know I said it was going to be a short video, a level two or a level three, check your certificates, check your, if you're level two, check your symbols, because at level two you get your symbols. Send me the pictures of the level two symbols. Then I will know what lineage you are and I can give you the appropriate advice, what way to go, if you'd like to do it like this, if you'd like to do it like that. It just means for me, as your teacher going forward, I am doing it in the way it was taught to me. I'm not in it for anything else. I've seen others who come to me and I say, look, I can't teach it because I'm not Tara May. I will teach you the way I have, go back and refresh. And within a space of 2 weeks, go out and say, oh, this just happened. And they get their Shiki Ryo certificate, even though they're level one, level two Tara May. That's not the way it was taught to me, and I won't be able to teach it to you in that way because it's just not what I do. If the other masters out there are not checking the other lineages, if they're going to them, that's not on me, it's on them. Your teacher, your Reiki master, should know this and should be checking to see what your lineages are and what your symbols are. You should never be taught different lineage if you haven't done the first two with them. Hope that makes sense. Anyway, it's again, and it's not about for me, it's not about rushing. I think that this energy is very powerful and we don't want to mess with it, so it is something that should be done in a slow progression, because excuse me, the guides are shutting me up now. It should be done in a slow progression because it's not only your energy you're working with, it's also the people that you're going to be working with, so you need to make sure that it's coming from the right space. A lovely clear body within yourself first, to be able to then be that clear channel to be able to allow that energy to flow for everybody else. So I hope that makes sense, and looking forward to the Reiki Master starting on Wednesday. 8 newbies who are going to go out the door to become amazing Reiki Masters, and it's a big energy already. The build up is already happening, so I won't be on this week because I'm going to be busy with that, but I hope all is good and enjoy your week. Namaste.